What's good, folks? It's Nightmare Frame here with a new Warframe video, coming at you with the best and ultimate melee weapons for Steel Path. These weapons were picked because of their insane damage output and the ability to be versatile in modding and gameplay. Now, if you love red crits and insane amounts of damage, then these weapons are for you. In my previous video where I talked over how to cheese Steel Path, I said less is always good. And as you can see in the background footage of my recent stream, I'm going up against level 4000 and above enemies without any elements or a Riven on my weapon. And I'm melting them. It's just smart modding and synergy. Now, this isn't going to be a top 10, top 5 list, but I'll give you a handful of weapons with the same modding principle, which can work with other weapons, but you do need to have a look at the stats and also be knowledgeable of the stances, as some stances can force proc physical damage types. These weapons consist of Primes and Zaws, which are modular weapons. The reason why these weapons are doing so well is because of two things: damage over time and simply multiplying that damage over time. And the damage over time that is used here is bleed. Slash is the strongest damage type in the game, as it provides you with status effect called bleed. It's a damage over time that stacks. Each single stack has its own timed instance. It scales off your raw damage mods and faction damage mods, and not physical damage type mods like Buzzkill. Those mods only increase the chance for a bleed to proc. And the slash damage will also scale from headshots and crits. And melees, weirdly enough, can headshot, as they can hit literally any part of the body. And all that bleed damage is dealt as true damage. True damage ignores all forms of defenses. And since I'm going up against pure armor, that armor means diddly squat. Some weapons here may not have slash as their main damage type, but they do have stances that can force proc slash, which will in turn bleed enemies. I will showcase the builds that we'll use on all of these melees. Yep, just two builds that works on all. Here we start off with Condition Overload for the scaling additive damage with each status effect on a target, Blood Rush for the scaling crit chance with your combo, Primed Reach for the increase in range to hit multiple targets to build up combo faster and deal damage in a wider area, Berserker for the scaling attack speed when critting, Organ Shatter for the critical multiplier, Weeping Wounds for the scaling status chance per combo, providing consistent and definite procs, and a Primed Smite mod of the faction you're going up against. These mods multiply the damage dealt, meaning you'll be doing 2 times more damage with bleeds against that faction. Do not underestimate these mods, guys. And the final mod can be whatever you want. You can run a Gladiator mod for the overall crits and utility, or Spring Loaded Blade for the increase in range. I run Spring Loaded Blade if I'm running a Helios with Detect Vulnerability and 3 Gladiator mods on my Deconstructor. And that is a non-elemental setup, clean and quite devastating. But what if you want to run elements? Now, the best element to complement bleed procs is Viral. And now that IPS bias doesn't exist, modding for elements is slightly different. That means there's no more physical damage types having a higher chance to proc than elements. So whichever one has the highest value will have a higher priority to proc. So when modding for elements, you want to have one mod to be ranked up once and the other one unranked, or sometimes both of them ranked up once or both unranked, depending on the slash distribution. And that's it. To maintain combos, you have Narumon, the best melee focus school, and Swift Momentum in the aura, or have a Riven which gives you combo duration. So, the weapons that I recommend. Starting off with Reaper Prime, Mastery Rank 10 Scythe, heavy in slash, great crit chance and status chance, easily hitting red crits without Gladiator mods. I'm utilizing the Reaping Spiral stance for the wide multi-hit chaining combos, and the stance even force proc slash, which is a bonus. I prefer the simple melee combo and sometimes the forward and block combo. Yes, you can build Reaper for heavy attacks, but I despise heavy attacks, and combos are just fluid and simpler to use. The next weapon in the list is the Pangolin Prime, a Mastery Rank 14 sword. It has amazing base damage, which is heavy in the slash department, with decent crit chance, amazing status, but unfortunately not the best attack speed. Utilizing the Crimson Dervish stance with the base melee combo, fast and has great penetration, which forces knockdowns, which increases your Condition Overload damage stack. Moving on to the Venka Prime, which I used to demonstrate this non-elemental build on my stream. It's a mastery rank 14 claw melee with brilliant crit chance, decent status chance, and a solid critical multiplier, and of course, heavy and slash, utilizing the Vermilion Storm stance, mostly using the forward and block combo, perfect for clearing massive groups of enemies. Moving on to the Sephon Nikana Zaw or a Nikana Prime, either one works great, but a Zaw can equip Exodia Hunt. Slam attacks will pull in enemies towards you, and enemies pulled with Exodia Hunt are susceptible to stealth multipliers and finishers, which is another damage increase. This Zaw is built from the Sephon Strike, Pay a Grip, and the Varjeet 2 Jai Link, which offers damage, crit, and speed. Zaws are not mastery locked, and they are untradeable. I'll be utilizing the Blind Justice stance, with the forward and block combo, and the basic melee combo. The forward and block has a slam attack, which can trigger Exodia Hunt, making it a devastating weapon. For more info and way more builds, do check out my Sephon Zaw build guide. Moving on to the Nami Skyla Prime. They are a Mastery Rank 11 dual swords. Decent crit chance, amazing status, and heavy in slash as well. Using the Crossing Snakes basic melee combo for quick burst of DPS. The best dual sword stance for instantaneous burst of damage. Moving on to the Cronin Prime, a Mastery Rank 13 Tomfa, with decent crit chance, great status, and brilliant attack speed, and it's high in slash. I'm utilizing the Sovereign Outcast stance with the main combo and the forward and block combo, which increases your range to ridiculous levels. The stance itself force proc slash, so that's another bonus. And the final pick is the Bala Zaw, built from the Bala Strike, Pay a Grip, and the Varjeet 2 Jai Link, which offers damage, crit, and great speed. Since the weapon isn't high in slash, I'll be utilizing the Stinging Thorn stance for the force slash procs with the combos. The forward and block combo and the basic melee combo are the go-to combos to use. The forward and block has a slam attack which can also trigger Exodia Hunt, allowing you to deal multiplicative damage all in one go. For more info and way more builds for this weapon, check out my Bala Zaw build guide. Alright, so these are my top weapons to annihilate enemies within Steel Path. You just carve through them like butter. Okay, folks, so that has been it from me. I do hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, feel free to leave a like, share, and
subscribe
for more Warframe content, streams, and so much more. Do refer to the description. Thanks for watching, and as always, peace.